say Selenium class 11 Java arrays and array list. In this class we are going to discuss two topics: Java arrays, Java arrays. Next, second one, Java array list. Array list. Array list is single word. Array list is single word. First, Java arrays. Anyhow, in our Selenium test automation, Java arrays limited use. Array list, I think, no use. Okay. Concept is there. Learn this one. Whenever you want to read tabular data, you can use Java arrays. In Java, array is object. In Java, array is an object that holds a fixed number of values of a single data type. Suppose if you create integer type array, you can store integer type elements only. If you create string type array, string type elements only. For example, in VBScript, you can store different types of values also. But in Java, formalities are there, single type of elements only. Observe this first point. In Java, array is an object. Array is an object that holds a fixed number of values of a single data type. In VBScript, we have dynamic arrays. Here, arrays are static. Java array is static. Next, the length of an array is established when the array is created. No dynamic array. See, the length of an array is established when the array is created. Next, array length is fixed. Index starts from 0. Array length is fixed. Here length means size of array, and index starts from 0. Okay, now Kamal, these three points.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, practical, declaring arrays. You come, Sita, declaring arrays. Say, in Java, array is an object. But in C language, array is variable. Scalar variables, array variables. In VBScript also, array is one type of variable. But in Java, array is object. But as like variable, you can use it. Usage is similar, but array is object in Java. Array is one type of variable in C language. You come, Sita. Declaring of arrays. We have three different methods available for declaring arrays, first method. First method. Sita is not responding. Can you interact, Sanjita? Sanjita. Hello? Sanjita also not responding. Krishna Kumari, can you interact?
Hello, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, Sanjita. Okay, continue. First, syntax. Syntax. Data type. Data type. Next. Array. Array name. Next. Square brackets equals to. Not equals to, just semicolon. Declaration of array. You put, Sanjita, some noise from your side.
Okay, sir.
Put mute for some time. Data type, array name, semicolon. Declaring an array. Declaring an array. Next, array. Array name equals to new keyword. Next, data type. Of means open bracket, square brackets. In this scenario, square brackets. Size, semicolon. Define size. Next. Array name. Next, index starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, like that up to n minus 1, size minus 1. Index equals to value, semicolon. Assign a value. Next index, like that. Kamal, observe example. Create one integer type array with size 3 and assign 3 values. First index 0, second index 1, third index 2. You can assign 10, 20, 30, like that. Create one integer type array with this syntax. Three steps syntax. Here, three steps. What are the three steps? First step, declaring array. Just a declaration. Second step, defining size of the array. Third step, assigning values. Third, multiple steps. Assigning values. Index 1. Index 0, index 1, index 2, like that. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Now, create a Java class. Select Java package. New Java class. Suppose arrays. Generate the main method. Okay. Next, create one integer type array.
Int?
No. Yes. Data type, na, good. Int?
Array name.
Array name, suppose A.
Equal to, square bracket.
Square brackets.
and semicolon.
Semicolon. This is declaration of array. Over. Next, define size. Suppose I want size 3. I want to store 3 elements. Index starts from 0, 0 to 3 minus 1, 2. 0, 1, 2. 3 values. A.
A. Square bracket.
A equals to.
A equal to.
New keyword.
Int.
Int of
int
size.
3.
3.
Semicolon.
Next, assign values to 3 elements.
A
of 0
equal to
equals 10. To suppose 10 semicolon. Next, A of
1
suppose 20
equals
to. A minute, equals to. This is assignment operator. Next, A of 2 equals
equal to
30 semicolon. Next, suppose system dot out dot println A of 1 plus this is addition A of 2. What is output? A of 1 plus A of 2.
50.
50. Good. Run the program. 50 in just a minute. This is about declaring an array, define size, and assign some values. Okay. Next, another flavor here, runtime error. Assign values to elements that more than the length of an array. See, assign values to elements that more than the length of array. Observe, in this scenario, array size is 3. We can assign 3 elements. Index starts from 0, 0, 1, 2. Suppose I am assigning one more element. Suppose A of 7 equals to some 70. Observe, Kamal, any error? Any syntax error?
No, sir.
No syntax error, but it will show runtime error. Runtime error. When? During execution. Run the program. Observe. Exception. Exception. Array index out of bounds. Exception here. How to handle this one, that we will discuss later. Anyhow, it is incorrect. It is runtime error. Runtime error. See, in this scenario, runtime error. Not syntax error. Syntax correct. Syntax correct. We used A of 7 equals to 70 semicolon. Syntax correct. Runtime error. Next example, assign values to some elements only. Assign. Values to some elements, not all elements. Some array elements. Some array elements only. Just a minute. Here, no issue. You can assign values to all elements or some elements. No issue. No issue. For example, int of 3. We can assign 3 values, but I am assigning only 1 value. I am not assigning 0. I am not assigning this one. Suppose a of 1. Earlier, no output, runtime error. This time it will print 20. No runtime error. No runtime error. 20. Okay, na? You observe Krishna Kumari. Suppose a of 0. What is the output? Last output. Krishna Kumari. Subramanyam. What is the last output? A of 0. We didn't assign A of 0. Kamal, why people are not responding?
0, it will take the default value.
Default value. Integer default value, 0. Run the program, 0. This is default value. Default value. Okay. Okay, now this concept, Kamal, assigning values to some array elements.
Yes, sir.
Some array elements, okay. All array elements, okay. But more than the array size, runtime error. Runtime error. Okay, and I will show one more flavor. Suppose A of 0, 10.23. Now observe, this is syntax error, na? It is Kamal, syntax error.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are giving.
We are going to assign another type of data. Yes. So, syntax error. Syntax error. This is syntax error. We can't execute. If it is no syntax error, we can execute. Sometimes you can get correct output. Sometimes you may get a runtime error. This is syntax error. System grammar error. Okay. In this example, we covered assigning values to all elements, correct output. Next, assigning values to some elements, correct output, correct usage. Next, assigning values that more than the size of array, runtime error. Next, assigning another type of data, another data type, that is syntax error. Okay. Chaitanya, you come. Second method. In first method, we followed 3 steps. You can use any one of the method for declaring and using arrays. You can use any one of the method to declare and use arrays. We will discuss all methods. Second method. In first method, we followed 3 steps. 3 steps, Chaitanya. What are the 3 steps?
First one is like we have to give the data type and array name.
Okay, array name means data type also. Okay.
Yes.
First,
yes.
We declared array, just array declaration.
Okay, sir. Array declaration.
Array declaration without size, without values. Just array declaration. Second step.
Second, we have to define the size of the arrays.
Define the size of the array. Okay. Third step.
We have to assign the values to the
values array. To the array elements. Here, third step, multiple steps. Depends on the size of the array. Okay. First one, single step. Second one, single step. Third one, multiple steps. Okay. Next, second method, only two steps. Only two steps. Observe the syntax. Then you have to guide. Data type. Square brackets. Array. Array name equals to new data type of size semicolon. Two steps over. One step, but two concepts over. Create or declare array, declare array with size or length with size. Next, array name, index, index equals to value. Semicolon. Assign a value. Assign a value. The second step, multiple. Suppose next index like that. Now create a same integer type array using these two steps. Chaitanya, guide me.
Yes. Int.
Int.
Square
suppose
brackets.
Square brackets.
You have to give the name.
Array name. Suppose A.
Equal to
equals
new.
To new keyword.
Int.
Int.
We have to give the size of the
array. Size of the array. Suppose 3. Okay. Next, assign values. Suppose
A.
Size 3. Index starts from 0. 0 to n minus 1. N means here 3. 3 minus 1, 2. 0 to 2. 0, 1, 2, 3 values. A of 0.
A of 0 equal to?
Suppose equals to, for example, 10. Next,
A of
1 equals to 20, just
and
a
of two.
Next, A of 2 equals to, suppose, 30. Here also same rules can be applicable. If you use more than the size, runtime error. Just print A of 0 plus A of 2. It will print 40. Okay, Chaitanya, I will call you later. 40, good. Just a minute. Just a minute. This is example. Example. Sita. Sita, can you hear me? Sita. Sita not responding. Subramanyam.
Yes.
Come Subramanyam. Third method. It is easy method. third method. Follow the syntax, then you have to guide me. For example, data type square brackets, array name equals to open curly braces, next value 1 value 2, next value 3 value 4, close curly braces, semicolon. Observe, declare an array and initialize. All three steps over na, Subramaniam? Observe, all three steps over na?
Yes.
Array declared, next size also based on your values. How many values are there?
Four
means size is 4. Next, values also you are defining. So, assigning values also over. Say, declaring array, size, next values. Only single step. In first method, 3 steps. Second method, 2 steps. Third method, single step. Now, assign 4 values. Create an array in using third method. And assign 4 values and perform one mathematical operation.
Int.
Int.
Array type.
Data type. Next, square brackets. Array name.
Array.
Equals to.
Assign the values.
Opens curly braces. Okay. Suppose 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40. Close. Semicolon. Next, perform one mathematical operation. System dot out dot println. A of 1 plus A of 2. What is the output?
30.
A of 1 means first 10, 0. Second 21.
30.
Third one, A of 2, 30. What is the output?
50.
50. Good. 50. Run the program. 50. And one more thing, you change this one. Suppose int a, just a minute, int a square brackets. Run the program. It is also correct syntax, na?
Yes.
It is also correct syntax. No problem. You can use this one also. See, this is syntax. Okay, you put mute, Subramaniam, I will call you later. This is syntax. This is example. Okay, next one, small comparison. Already I told, in VB script, no restrictions for storing values. Observe, using dim statement, dim, dimension. Using dim statement, we create variables and arrays in VB script. We use VB script in UFT. Suppose dim A of 4, we can no semicolon. we can store four values. Suppose a of 0 equals to 10. Here comment symbol is single quote. This is integer. First of all, what is this a? It is variant. No data type specification. No explicit data type specification in VB script. Only implicit. Implicit means no data type specification. So it is variant. It can vary based on the values. Suppose a of 1 equals to ABCD. Yes, it is also correct usage. Internally, it considers string type data. Next, a of 2 equals to 10.234. Yes, it will accept. Internally, it considers double type data. Suppose a of 3 fourth value, again you are using integer type. Yes, internally it considers integer. In VB script it will accept, but in Java it won't accept. Padmasri, can you hear me? Padmasri.
Yeah, I can hear.
Okay, cool. You come Padmasri. One or two examples on arrays. Remaining examples we will discuss in built-in methods chapter or predefined methods in Java. There we will discuss string methods, array methods, number methods and character methods. Observe my example. This is not example, just creating different type arrays. Declare or create different type arrays using third method. For example, using third method, you can follow first method or second method also. First declare integer type array. Int.
Array name.
Square brackets. Array name equals to assign values directly. 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay. Semicolon. What is this one? Array of integers. Next, character type array. Char square brackets b equals to open curly braces. Here single quotes for numbers, no quotes, just 10, 20, 30. But for characters, single quote. Suppose A, next B, not only alphabets. Suppose 1, it is also a character. Suppose special character, it is also a character. Close. What is the size of A array, first array?
3.
What is the size of first array?
3.
Pardon?
3.
3. 3 or 4? 4. But
yeah, four.
Index starts from 0. 0 to 0. 3. 0 to 3. Yeah. But 4. Yes, what is the size of second array?
4.
4 only. Good. Next, array. Array of characters. Array of characters. Next, string type array. String is object in Java. String, square brackets. Suppose C equals to, for strings, double quotes required. You can use any value. Suppose UFT. This is alphabet. Next, Selenium. Alphabet. Suppose 1, 2, 3 numbers. Suppose India 1, 2, 3 alphanumeric. Yes, string only. Semicolon. Array. Array of strings. Array of strings. Next, create one double type array. Double type array.
Double
square brackets. Suppose D equals to open curly braces. Suppose 10.23. No quotes. It is number. Okay. Number with decimal places, but number only. Next, 2.456. Next, 20.345. Next, 11.234. Close. What is this one? Array of decimal point values. Array of decimal point values. Next, Boolean type array. Boolean, square brackets. For example, Boolean name is E. Array name is E. Open curly braces. Only two type of values. True
or false.
False. False. True. Four values. Semicolon. Next, for example, system.println, system.out.println, A of 2. What is the output?
30.
A of 2, 30. Good. Next, system.out.println of C of 1.
Selenium.
Good. Selenium. Run the program. 30 Selenium. Two outputs in this program. Okay, 30 Selenium. You can check remaining also. Okay, Padmasri, I will call you later. Ahalya, can you hear me? Ahalya not responding. What about you, Krishna Kumari? Can you interact? Krishna Kumari.
Yes, sir.
Okay, cool. You come. Another example. Copy values from one array to another. Okay. Here we are discussing some small examples only for arrays. In array methods chapter, we will discuss remaining important operations. Anyhow, array, limited use or no use in our test automation. Whenever you want to read table or data, you can use array. Anyhow, limited use. Observe. Copy values from one array to another. One array to another. Declare one array, suppose int square brackets array 1 equals to assign values, integer type values, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, close curly braces, semicolon. Next, create one more array, int square brackets
array 2
equals to array 1
string, okay,
array 1 semicolon. Now print the length of first array, observe, SYSO, control space enter, just a minute. We are not using Eclipse editor, notepad we are using. Array 2, array 1, spell mistake, array 1. Next, SYSO, control space enter, array 1 dot length. It is property, it is not method, property. What is the output?
4.
4, good. 4. Next, system dot out dot println, array 2 dot length. We didn't define array 2 length and we didn't assign any values, but we copied array 1. What is the output?
4.
4. Suppose system dot out dot println array 2 of 2. What is the output?
2.
Array 2 of 2.
Yeah, 2, sir.
Not 2, 3.
Oh, yeah, 3.
3. How? Why? This is 0 index. 1 is 0 index.
Okay.
This is 1. This is 2. Here we are specifying index. Index 2 means right. Value 3.
Right.
Run the program. 4, 4, 3. This is about copying all values from one array to another. One array to another. Copying all values. Next, you only continue Krishna Kumari. Complex, some complex, not big. Print all elements of an array using for loop. Print all elements of an array using for loop. All elements. Suppose this is the array. This is the array. Print all elements. Suppose 4, 5.
For int.
For int. What is the starting value?
0. I equals to
0. 0 index. Index.
Yeah.
Semicolon. Next, end I value.
End value, I array 1 dot.
Just a minute. I.
Less than.
Good. Less than.
Array 1.
Array 1 dot.
Length.
Anyhow, length minus 1, so less than.
Yeah.
Semicolon.
Increment. I plus plus.
I plus plus. I plus plus. Open curly braces. Next. System dot out dot println of of
I.
I is index na.
Array one of, sorry.
Good. Array one of
I.
I is just index. Okay.
Yeah, right.
Run the program. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, good. Okay, Krishna Kumari, I will call you later. You come, Sanjita. Why today so many people? Sanjita, can you guide me for another example? Okay, na Sanjita?
Yeah, sir. Okay.
Okay, cool, Sanjita. Why today Sita is not responding? Ahalya is not responding. Okay. This time, print all elements of an array using enhanced for loop. You can use any one flavor, any one usage, but more than one way available. Already I told, what is the computer programming motto? Okay, Sita, good. Okay. What is the computer programming motto, Sanjita? More than one way to achieve any task in computer programming. Select simplest way. Getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Now, print all elements of an array using enhanced for loop. Now, observe enhanced for loop. You know the syntax of enhanced for loop. Can you tell me?
Yes, sir.
Using enhanced
for loop,
this is integer type array.
For
open parenthesis.
Open integer.
Next, integer. Suppose
square bracket.
Variable declaration.
Array one.
Variable.
Yeah, array one.
No. Observe. Declaring variable na. In enhanced
yes,
for loop. Suppose what type of array? Integer type. Declare integer type variable. Why? It has to store integer values. One by one. If you declare integer type array in enhanced for loop, declare integer type variable for storing integer type data one by one. Okay? Num colon. Now continue.
Array
name.
One.
Array. Array one.
Then open bracket, curly bracket.
Curly braces. Good. Curly braces.
Okay.
Remove this one. Curly braces. Array one. Why it is showing? Array one we declared.
We have to close the
pardon?
Break. We have to close the bracket like okay, integer.
Okay. This one I mistakenly removed. Next.
Then SYSO.
SYSO control space enter.
Then it is a num.
Num. Num. It will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Run the program. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, good, Sanjita. I'll call you later.
Okay.
You come, Kamal. We are printing.
Yes, sir.
We copied all elements. We printed all elements. This time, copy particular element. Copy particular element. Copy particular array element. Particular array element. Direct example. Suppose int square brackets array 1 equals to open curly braces 1, 2, 4, 6, close curly braces, semicolon. Next, I want to copy value of 4 to another array. Value of 4 to another array. Int square brackets array 2 equals to curly braces array of 2, close curly braces, just a minute. Oh, array 1 of 2, semicolon. Next, system dot out dot println array 2 of 2, array 2 of 2, array 2 of 2. Oh, spell mistake. Okay. Now tell me the output, Kamal.
Sir, we have declared only one element in array 2. How it will print array 2 of 2? It will show error.
Error? What is the key value? 1, 2, 4, I think. Oh, error.
We have taken only one element in the array 2, sir. Now it will print 4.
4. It is storing in 0th position.
Yeah.
0th position. For example, 2 of 2, is it correct? No, incorrect syntax. It will store.
We can take another element in the array 2, like array 1, 2, comma 1, comma 2, comma 3, like that.
Mm-hmm.
We can take other values also in array 2. Like at 0 index, we have taken array 1 of 2. We can have other values also if you want to.
Okay. It is storing in 0th position. 0th position. How to store in second position only?
First, array 2 equal to curly braces 1, comma 2, comma array 1, 2, like
That is complex. Enough. Anyhow, it is limited use. It is storing into first position. Any problem, Kamal?
No problem, sir.
Okay, cool.
I'm good.
Next. Anyhow, it is no use. Just an idea. Create or declare. It is no use in our test automation. Create or declare 2D, two dimension, 2D array. suppose int square brackets, again square brackets, array 1 equals to open curly braces, again open curly braces, 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40, close, next, suppose 15 comma 25 comma 35 comma 45, close, semicolon. This is about defining 2D array, but no use in our test automation, so don't focus on this one. Next, advantages of arrays. Advantages of arrays. Advantages of arrays. Using arrays, we can optimize the code. Data can be retrieved easily. See, using arrays, we can optimize the code and data can be retrieved easily. Next, we can get required data using index position. We can get required data using index position. Next, disadvantage of Java array. In VBScript array, it is not a disadvantage. It is not a disadvantage. Disadvantages. We can store fixed number of elements only. It doesn't change its size during execution. We can store fixed number of elements only. Only. And it doesn't change its size during execution. See, this is about arrays. This is about arrays. And one small general topic. You observe Ahalya not responding. You observe Sanjita. Observe small general point. Java array is static data structure. Java array is static data structure and array list, single word, array list is dynamic data structure. Observe Sanjita, one small comparison. In VBScript, I'm declaring variables. Observe dim a comma b of 4 here. Use parenthesis in VBScript. Parenthesis. b of 4, but in Java square brackets, comma c. C is dynamic array whose size is not defined. Later we can increase or decrease the size. We can define the size. Later we can increase or decrease the C array. It is dynamic. Dynamic array. Next, D is two dimensional array. Observe. In this declaration, in this statement, we declared four variables. A is scalar variable, or you can say just variable. Scalar variable means it is for storing one value at a time. Next, B, array variable. In VB script, array is variable, one type of variable. Next, C is dynamic array. Dynamic array. Next, D is two dimensional array. Observe. VB script. Next, Java. Next, I am taking one more language. It is also scripting language. Perl written in Perl wrote in C language. Perl is scripting language. Java is programming language. VBScript is scripting language. It is a lightweight version of VB.NET. Lightweight version of VB programming language. Here, scalar variables means for storing one value at a time. Observe in this declaration, A is scalar variable. Next, in Java also we have scalar variables, primitive data types scalar variables, but we just say variable. Yes, variable or scalar variable. Scalar variable. In Perl also, scalar variable. Next, observe Kamal. Okay, Sanjita, I will call you later. Observe Kamal. Array variable.
Yes, sir.
Array variable. Array variable. Here array is not variable. Array is object.
Array is object.
Yes. Array object. Here we use array object. Next, here same array variables. Array variable. Next, third one. In Perl script, third type of variables, hash variables. Hash variable, another name of this hash variable, associated array. No third type of variable in VB script. Equivalent feature is, observe Krishna Kumari, I think you are familiar with UFT, VB script. Here, similar is dictionary object is equivalent to associated array in Perl script. associated array or hash variable. Here array list is not exact equal to dictionary object, but some equivalent. In VB script, two types of variables. In Perl script, three types of variables. In VB script, in Java, one type of variable only. Next, you can use array object as array, array list as associated array. Okay, now come to Kamal. Any confusion, Kamal? This one?
No, sir.
How many types of variables available in Perl script out of syllabus?
Three types of variables. Scalar, array, and hash variables.
Hash variables. Okay. Just a minute. Now come to our second topic. This one no use in our test automation. Okay. Array list. First, array versus array list in Java. Array versus array list. Suppose array example. Array example, int square brackets a equals to, I'm using second syntax, a of 4 semicolon, a of 0 equals to 10. Second value, third value, fourth value. Suppose 1, 2, 3. Suppose 20, 30, 40. Suppose A of 5 equals to 50. It is just a minute. Runtime error. Okay. But in array list, what will happen? You can observe. In array list, user can define values dynamically. Next, ArrayList is dynamic data structure. ArrayList is dynamic data structure, and we can add or remove elements. We can add or remove elements dynamically. Before going to discuss the example, note ArrayList. ArrayList is not built in but predefined. Predefined class that we have to import. Import from java.util package. util. Package java dot util package. Now you come, Kamal. My example is create an array list and conduct some operations. Follow this syntax. Here we have to follow this syntax. We can't argue this syntax. Some different kind of object creation here. Observe. Suppose I am going to create integer type of array list. Array list. Next, angular brackets. Data type. Integer. Here you write integer, not primitive data type int. Integer. Observe, this integer also predefined class, na? Observe, Kamal.
Yes, sir.
This integer, yes, also predefined class. It is not primitive data type int. So write integer. It is predefined class. Next, array list. We didn't import, na? We didn't import. Okay. ABC. ABC is array list name equals to new array list. Next, open and close angular brackets. Open and close brackets. Semicolon. This is the syntax. Now it is showing red color. Why? Import array list from java.util. Say it is guidance. Okay. Next, add ABC. Now it is object. What type of object? Array list object. What type of array list? Integer type. Dot add of 100. It will take to first index. First index is 0. Next, ABC dot add 200. Next, 300. You can add or remove elements dynamically. Now observe first operation, Kamal. Print an array list element. Print an array list. Array list element. Print an array list element. Suppose I want to print 100. What is the index of 100?
0.
0. You take into variable that is integer type data. First take into variable. Suppose int res equals to abc dot get predefined method get index 0. Next, you can use this res variable. SYSO control space enter res. It will print 100. Run the program. Suppose you don't want to take into variable, just print. Just print Kamal or ABC dot get 0 100 100 100. Run the program 100 100. Next, return size of array list, another operation. Return size of the array list. We can take into variable, otherwise direct display. SYSO control space enter. ABC dot size. What is the size?
3 3 3.
Run the program 100 100 3 100 100 3. Suppose I am adding one more element. You can add or remove elements dynamically. ABCD dot add of, suppose 400, 400, one more element. Next, now tell me the size. Now last output.
Four.
Run the program 4. Okay, next remove an element. Suppose ABC dot remove, suppose index position 1. Now elements. Size 3, last output 3 3. Okay, now print the first element. First element removed na, but it will adjust the elements. Print the first element. Suppose SYSO control space enter. ABC dot get of 1. What is the output? 1 removed. 1 value is 200. 0 is 100. 1 value 200. 1 removed. But we'll adjust. Pardon?
Yeah. The answer is 300. 300 to 1.
300. It will adjust. Suppose third element to second element. It will adjust. 300. Run the program. Last one 300. Last one 300. Next. Chaitanya. Okay, Kamal, I will call you later. Print all elements in array list. Print all elements. We have 100, 200 removed, 300, next 400, 100, 300, 400.
And
print all elements using for loop. Using for loop.
For loop.
For loop. For.
For.
Int. Suppose i, index, I equals to index starts from 0, semicolon, next, end value.
End value, there are 3, sir.
3. Suppose if it is small number, you can identify 3. Suppose if it is lengthy or you are reading data from any external file, you cannot use that hard code value, na? You have to use formula.
Yes, sir.
I less than array list dot size, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Again, semicolon, I plus plus.
I plus.
Open curly braces. Next. SYS to control space enter.
ABC.
Good. ABC dot get of index. Get of
index.
What is the index? I.
Yes, sir.
Observe. Last output. 100, 300, 400, 200 already removed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 100, 300, 400. Okay, Chaitanya, I will call you later. 100, 300, 400. Continue, Kamal. Check the existence of elements. Just a minute. Remove an element. Check the existence of elements. Check the existence. Observe, Kamal. System dot out dot println abc dot contains 200 value in your array list, value of element in your array list. It returns Boolean result. Now tell me, 35th statement output, Kamal,
false.
200
false.
Already removed.
Yeah, it will return false.
False. It is false. It will, 400 is available. Observe the last two outputs. False true. Okay, na? False true. Next, remove all elements. Remove all elements. ABC dot clear. Clear. Next, SYSO control space enter. ABC dot size. What is the last statement output?
Zero.
Zero. Zero. Run the program. Last one, zero. Last one. This is operations on array list. Okay. I will provide one small example. Now you come, Subramanyam. All of you put mute except Subramanyam. Small example, Subramanyam. Create a string type array. A string type array list. Array list single word. Create a string type array list. Next, add one value and get the value. Add one value, get the value. Simple example. Oh. Guide me. Create one string type array. String type array. Subramanyam.
Array.
Array list.
Data type.
Array list. Angular brackets. Next, data type. String.
String dot array.
String. Next, string name. Suppose ABC string. Equals to new keyword. Next, array list. Angular brackets. Parentheses or general brackets. Semicolon. Next, import array list. Import. Next, add one element. Suppose
ABC.
ABC dot add
array list.
Suppose value Selenium. Selenium. Get that value. Return that value. You don't need to take into variable. Just direct display. SYSO control space enter abc dot get. What is the index get. Position? Zero. It will return
yes.
Selenium. Run the program. Selenium. This is about array list. Next, end of the day, I will provide one general topic. General topic. You come. Padmasri. Padmasri, are you there? All of you put mute except Padmasri. Padmasri.
Yes.
Okay, cool. Continue, Padmasri. Last topic in the day. Types of input. Types of output. Types of output in Java. Types of output in Java. Say, the output of computer programming, not only in Java, basically four types. The output of computer programming is basically four types. General topic, but important one. General but important. Four types. First one, value based result or output. Value based output. It is fixed. Next, second one, Boolean, or another name is logical output. True or false. Next, third one, constant based result, built-in constants. I will show constant based result or output. Output. Next, fourth one, dynamic result. Dynamic result. First I am taking value based. It is perfect result, value based. Arithmetic operators and some predefined methods. Arithmetic operators and some predefined methods, not all, but all arithmetic, return this type of value based results. See, arithmetic operators, arithmetic operators and some predefined, or you can say built-in, some built-in methods return value based result. Output. Example. Tell me, Padmasri, we have four types of output in computer programming. What are the four types of output?
Value based output.
Mm-hmm.
And the second one is Boolean or logical output.
Good. Third one?
Third one is constant based result.
Mm-hmm.
And fourth one is dynamic result.
Dynamic result. Okay. Observe the example for first one. Example for first one. Suppose system.out.println. 10 plus 3, output is 13. It is value, fixed. Suppose if you execute this program 10 times, same output, 20 times, same outputs. See, run the program, 13. Next iteration, 13. If you execute this program n number of times, same output for every time. Next, suppose SYSO control space enter 5 into 6. It is also arithmetic operator. Same output. Run the program. 13, 30. Next, some built-in methods I told na. Suppose SYSO control space enter math dot max, find the maximum number. Suppose 10, 7. What is the output of last statement, Padmasri? What is the output of last statement? It finds maximum number
10.
It is also fixed. Run the program, 13, 30, 10. Second time, 13, 30, 10. It is not logical result, value based result. This is first one. Okay, Padmasri, I will call you later. You come, Krishna Kumari. Second one. Boolean or logical result. Boolean or logical result. Relational. Relational or another name of relational operators. What is the another name of relational operators? I think Kamal can answer it. Another name of relational operators, Kamal?
Arithmetic.
No. Arithmetic is entire different. I think Kamal can answer it. Relational operators are
logical.
Logical is another category. Arithmetic is another category. Logical is another category. Comparison. Relational operators are relational or comparison operators and some predefined methods are written Boolean or logical result. Boolean or logical result. Example. SOSO. I'm using direct statements. Suppose 100 greater than 99. Next, SOSO control space enter. 100 less than 99. Next, 100 greater than 99. First one, 100 less than 99. What is the output, Krishna Kumari? 100 less than 99.
Yeah, that's true, sir.
True. 100 less than 99.
Yes. Sorry. False, sir.
Good. False.
Sorry.
Next. Just.
It's true.
Second one. 100 greater than 99.
True.
This is Boolean result, not value based result. Some predefined methods. SOSO control space enter. Capital ABC. ABC. It is string. String is object dot equals small ABC. Small ABC. Next, SOSO control space enter. Java dot equals Java. Now observe Krishna Kumari, first output, capital ABC, small ABC. Both are same or different?
Same, sir.
Not same. It compares as per ASCII values, na?
Oh, yeah.
ANSI character codes. Capital A is, capital A ANSI value is different from small a.
Right.
So, yeah. Both are different. So, false. Next, observe. Second one.
Both values are same.
Both true. Values are same. So true. Boolean result. See, observe. First, sixth statement. Boolean result. Operators, which operator? Relational or comparison operators returning this Boolean result. Ninth statement.
Yeah.
Equals method. Predefined method returning this Boolean result. First two outputs, operators. Second two outputs, methods, predefined methods. This is second type of result. Okay, Krishna Kumari, you put mute. You come, Sanjita. Third one. constant, constant based output. Output. Observe, in three-way comparison, a three-way comparison of numbers. See, three-way. Two-way comparison, false, true. True and false. True or false. In two-way comparison, output true or false. In three-way comparison of numbers, equals to, greater than, less than. Three-way comparison of integers. Observe. If number one greater number one less than number two, number two, then minus one. If just a minute. Number one equals to number two, then zero. Next, if number one greater than plus one, positive one, just one. Observe Sanjita. These are constant, constant based result. Suppose, what are these? Minus one, zero, one. This is not logical, not value based only, but not mathematical calculations. Observe here, minus 1, 0 and 1 are built in constants. Fixed only, built-in constants. Getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Any confusion, ask me.
No, sir.
Okay, cool. Example. Observe the example. Observe. You don't focus on this example. In built-in methods chapter, we will discuss. Built-in methods. Suppose int a equals to 7. Int a equals to 7. Next, I am converting this primitive data type int to integer object. I am wrapping the code. Don't focus on this one. Integer x equals to a. Kamal, did you observe this this usage?
I am sir.
A is integer, primitive data type, na?
Yes, sir.
I am wrapping that code as integer. Now, a to x. Now what is the x? X is integer object, na?
X is integer object here. Yeah.
Integer object. What is the x value?
7.
We assigned a 7. Integer is, yes. X is object. Integer object. Value is 7. We assigned it. Primitive data type int 7 value. Okay, anyhow, that we will discuss in built-in methods chapter. Just a minute. SYSO control space enter. X is object. What type of object? Integer type object. Value. What is the value of x? 7. dot compare to suppose 9 constant based result. Just a minute, observe Sanjita, second one, third one, 7, next 4, 5, now tell me Sanjita, first output, 9th statement, x compared to 9, x value 7, x is object now, that's why we are using built-in methods, we are applying the methods, what is the output?
False.
Not true or false. Constant based result. Three-way comparison.
Okay.
Less than, so equal is, to, greater than. Not true or false. Yes, Sita.
Good. Answer is 1.
Pardon? Sita answered correctly. Now tell me Sanjita, what is the correct answer? 9th statement. First value,
yeah,
x is 7. 7. First number, 7 less than 9. What is the output?
Minus 1.
Minus 1. Next, x value 7 compared to 7 only. Output?
Yeah. 0.
0. Next, x value 7 compared to 5 means x greater than 5.
1.
Run the program. Minus 1, 0, 1. These are fixed but not mathematical value, calculated value. Constant value. Built-in constants. Fixed but constants. This is one type of output in computer programming. Okay, Sanjita, you put mute. For last one, you come Subramanyam. Subramanyam. Dynamic result. Dynamic result. Generate. Just a minute. Generate random numbers. That generating random number depends on compiler. Next, examples. Return system date. First one, generate random number. Observe SYSO control space enter system dot out dot println. Math, it is predefined class, predefined. Observe math available in lang package, math dot random. It will provide a random number, if it is integer or decimal point value. Observe Subramanyam, observe the value 0.4309 something. Second time 0.4248. Third time 0.21. Fourth time 0.29. Every time dynamic output, na?
Yeah.
Every time dynamic output. Next. Return system date. System date. Here object required, date object, date.
Based on which number it's calculating, method or random function?
Pardon?
Based on which number calculating, method or random function here?
It returns numbers randomly based on the compiler.
Okay, not any
logic.
Okay.
No logic for returning this number. Based on that compiler, it will assign any one random number.
Okay.
But every time different number. Means every time unique number. New date. I am creating data object for returning system date. Import date from java.util. Next, SYSO control space enter date. Run the program. Observe Subramaniam, it is returning date and time na?
Yes.
June 19, 8:22:41 IST 2018. Run the program once again. This time 23:02. Next time 23:09. That output is dynamically changing na?
Yes, sir.
Suppose if you execute this program tomorrow, it will show June 20. Suppose if you execute this program next year, 2019, dynamic. Suppose 5 plus 3, 8. If you execute this program tomorrow, 8 only. If you execute this program after 10 years, 8 only. Getting this point?
Yeah.
This is dynamic result. See, this is about four types of output in computer programming. Any queries, Subramaniam?
No, good.
Okay, cool. Tomorrow we will discuss Java IO, that is important. Today I am going to close the session, confirm one by one. First, Ahalya not responding today. Ahalya, any queries regarding this today's class? Okay. Chaitanya, any queries? Today we discussed three topics, Chaitanya. What are the three topics? Okay.
Sir?
Ahalya, good.
Sir.
Continue, Chaitanya.
Sir, we discussed about arrays.
Arrays.
ArrayList.
ArrayList.
And then at the end of the class, we discussed about the outputs.
Types of output in Java.
Types of outputs in Java, sir.
Good. Welcome. Any queries?
No, sir. I'm clear, sir.
Welcome. Kamal, any queries regarding this today's class?
No, sir. I'm good. Thank you.
Welcome. Welcome, Chaitanya. Padmas, Krishna Kumari.
I'm good, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Padmasri.
I'm clear, sir. Thank you.
Any queries?
No, sir. I'm clear. Thank
Welcome.
You.
Sanjita.
I'm good, sir. Thank you.
Welcome, Sanjita. Sita not able to respond. Na? Subramaniam, any queries regarding this today's class? Welcome,
no,
Sita. Subramaniam.
No, thank you.
Okay, good. Welcome, Subramaniam. Okay, we will meet tomorrow. Same time. Thank you.